period showed the fastest increase in terms of the incidence rates compared to any other cancers. But the causes and the risk factor which responsible for those observed increasing trends are largely unclear. So right now, there are a couple different, you know, explanations for those. The first, the increased medical attention to thyroid nodules has resulted in a large proportion of small thyroid being diagnosed. But it cannot fully explain all the observed increasing trend. Thyroid cancer incidence rates has increased almost three times from 1994 to 2009. For example, for women, before it's like 6.6 per 100,000 people, but right now it's already 21.4 per 100,000 people. So it becomes the fifth most common. Before it's a very rare cancer. So now we try to study, you know, what exact environmental risk factors could be responsible for those increasing trends. So currently we are speculating two major environmental risk factors. One is increased radiation exposure, particularly the diagnostic X-ray exposure. And another is environmental chemicals like flame retardants, which have been demonstrated in animal studies can change the thyroid hormone levels, which is a major key point for developing thyroid cancer. So the flame retardants actually is existing almost everywhere. This kind of bioregulation, all the furniture or construction materials have to contain those flame retardants to prevent fire. So the first study was funded by the American Cancer Society in 2010. It's a population-based case control study in Connecticut. We're planning to recruit 450 cases, thyroid cancer cases, and 450 population-based healthy controls. We're trying to investigate the radiation exposure, DNA repair capacity, and the risk of thyroid cancer. So this is, we're using the questionnaire interview to collecting all those exposure information. So it is mandatory for US military people to have HIV testing every 2 years. So the serum repository archives all those serums following the testing. So they almost representing 100% of the personnel in the US military. So we're using pre-diagnostic serum samples. As we know, the disease itself and its treatment might affect the serum concentrations of all those environmental chemicals levels. So we, using those pre-diagnostic serum sample, will not bias the results. And there will be a great opportunity for us to address the causal relationship between the environmental chemicals and the thyroid cancer risk. There's just a recent report showed that incidence rates of thyroid cancer in military people even higher than the general population.